Spanish Phonetics.
Breaking connections to the world.
Becoming language on demand.
Let's bring the world of learning in one channel.
Welcome to BCBS Phonetics English TV.
So hi dear learners, how are you? It's me again, Ma'am Ladylyn Bayani. And welcome to our weeks 5 and 6 of our quarter 2. And before we proceed to our new lesson, let us have first a short recap on our previous topic, and that is making annotations. Yes, from our previous video, we have learned about annotating, and that is to make marks on the text. But it is not simply as highlighting appealing words on sentences. We have to keep in mind that annotating is deconstructing text into meaningful pieces for better understanding. Okay? And for this week's lesson, we have unchanging values in the VUCA world. And yes, that is our topic for today about VUCA. V-U-C-A, where V stands for volatile, U for uncertain, C for complex, and A for ambiguous. And that is how our world is being described. And there is a need for us to understand the unchanging values in this kind of world. Now, let us have our objectives. At the end of the lesson, learners are expected to analyze literature as means of valuing other people in other various circumstances in life, evaluate specific values in texts, and create representation of characters by relating the text in today's society. And we are also targeting the most essential learning competency, and that is analyze literature as means of understanding unchanging values in the VUCA world. Values are passed from culture to culture, from generation to generation. But we all know that everything can change in just a snap. Even in science, a solid can transform into liquid, that is, ice that melts and become water, or a liquid to gas when a boiling water evaporates. See how fast things change?
It was Warren Bennis and Bert Nanos who first used in 1987 the acronym VUCA on their leadership theories, which stands for volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity.
Let me share you a tip. In a VUCA world, the most important thing is to anticipate the future and strengthen cooperation to come up with better solutions to problems and challenges.
According to a research at Columbia University, there is scientific data that learning agility, or the ability to be flexible and be open to change and thrive on new experiences, is made up of 9 dimensions or behavior patterns. We have, first, flexibility, or the willingness to try new things. Second, speed, or the rapidly grasping new ideas. Experimenting, testing out new ideas. Performing risk-taking, which is taking on challenges. Interpersonal risk-taking, which is asking for others' help. Collaborating or leveraging the skills of others. Information gathering, which is increasing your knowledge. Feedback seeking, asking for feedback. And the last, reflecting, or taking time to reflect on your effectiveness.
Literature provides us with a range of exposure and experiences that may open doors to understanding these unchanging values amid the fast-paced VUCA world.
let me introduce you students a piece of literature that reflects these values which still thrive despite the modern changes in the society.
In your module, on pages 25 to 26, you'll see a narrative summary of the epic Beowulf. It is a literary work considered to be the famous literary writing of Old English literature. It tells the heroic deeds of Beowulf, who rescued the Danes from the monster Grendel and his mother. 50 years later, Beowulf died saving his own people, the Geats, from a fire-breathing dragon. The anonymous poet who wrote the epic captured the spirit of Germanic tribal life and language. I hope that all of you enjoyed reading the summary of the epic Beowulf. Now, let us try answering the activities and learning tasks for this week. For our first activity, you guys are going to read and analyze the poem and evaluate the specific values embedded in the given text. Then, answer and reflect on the questions that follow. Here is the poem. It is entitled, When I Was 1 and 20. Reflection question number 1. What is the theme portrayed by the poem? Number 2. What specific attitude of the young towards life is shown in the text? Number 3. What specific advice was given by the wise man to the young man? 4. Did the young man listen to the advice of the wise man? Explain your answer. 5. Based on the text, how does the wise man perceive life? And last, how will you explain the idea of wisdom of elders in the given poem? Relate your answer to your personal experiences. For our learning task number 2, having read the epic Beowulf, answer the following questions. Number 1. Why did Beowulf decide to free the Danes from Grendel? 2. Why did Beowulf fight Grendel with his bare hands? What does this reveal about his character? 3. Why was it harder for Beowulf to kill Grendel's mother than Grendel himself? 4. What were the qualities deeply esteemed by the people of those times? Would those qualities be equally esteemed in our times? Number 5. We have to complete the story. You may pause this video to answer and complete the story. For our learning task number 3, analyze the characters in the epic Beowulf by providing significant information about them and relating them to the present time. Please use the template or the table below for your answers. We have here the characters Beowulf, King Hrothgar, Grendel, Grendel's mother, Wiglaf, and the dragon. On the second column, you'll see the significant details about the character, and on the third column, you're going to write the representation of the character in the present society. And that's it! Keep going, grade 9 learners, and happy learning! Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to like and subscribe on our YouTube channel, Disabes MNHS English TV.